forward the area. There we go. That's good. Do we have pet owners in the room? Anybody have pets? Beyond, what do you have?
Dog.
A dog? What's the dog's name?
Smothers.
Smuggles. That's a good dog name because it's clearly a dog name or maybe a very special child. But I think it's kind of like whenever people have a pet and they name it a human name that makes you feel less human. Essentially because, you know, you think Smuggles, that's a part of your family. You know, you think they're like family. But I don't know that. So when you tell me something about it, I'm confused. Like, oh, Sarah's got cancer. Oh my God, I'm so sorry. He asked me $5,000 to fix. Oh man, let's get her skin started going. Nah, we're gonna let her go. What? She's 12, she had a good bun. Oh my God! What? We can always get another one. Oh, that's terrible. And I find out it's a dog. I'm like, you know what? I hope your daughter doesn't get cancer. That's terrible. Like I said, it makes me feel terrible. I'm not a good person. Another thing that makes me bad is that inspirational slogans don't. They don't faze me. They don't have that effect. There was this one where they said, like Amelia Earhart said, the most appropriate way to do something is to just do it. And I don't feel good taking directions from someone who is notoriously lost. All right. I don't think she has a room to stand, a leg to stand on, a wing to stand on at all. You know, something about that bothers me. The another one, John Lennon. He said, it's okay till the end, and if it's not okay, it's not the end. He was assassinated, so it didn't work out so well for him. Vincent Van Gogh said, great things are done by a series of small things put together. So when you cut your ear off, when you make it like human confetti, what does that mean? That's art snob joke. Okay, it's, we'll figure it out. We'll figure it out. Yeah, I don't know. There's a... cynical in the world, just had Valentine's Day. Everybody have a good Valentine's Day? Not so much. It was like, the fire's kind of gone. I get it. It's, I tried to impress my girlfriend. I got her a massage, and I got a couple's massage. Bad idea, because they asked me, like, I went there. I'm too weird for that. I don't know, because and the massage service is like, okay, let me know if you want to adjust the pressure. I'm like, all right, how's that going to go? All right, I'm gonna say, oh, it's too hard. Oh, man, harder. I'm a freak. You know, that's weird. They try to set the mood. We went home, and I put on one of those Netflix fireplace videos. Have you ever seen one of those? I was kind of disappointed because the average review is 4 out of 5 stars. So then, 4 out of 5. Where the hell are you in your life to judge a fireplace video? Okay. There is a director for that, all right? He went to film school. He has to explain to his family what he's doing with his life. He's like, no, Mom, you understand. It's art. I'm talking to people, you know? You're like, the worst part of the day is when the stage hand's trying to roast marshmallows, ruining the shot. Ah! Save it for the blooper reel. And anymore, that's the only video you haven't watched all the way through. I don't know, unless you're like a pyromaniac and you get off on that kind of thing. And so you're like, you know what? I see simulated fire expert in that. 4 stars. 4 stars. Cool. So far, I gave this audience 3 stars. If you're working on it like that. I just got a job. I work at a law firm. You know, just for fun. This is where the real money's at. It was weird because I got the job through Craigslist. It's very odd to earn a paycheck from the same place that you get used furniture and hand jobs, and now it contributes to my 401k. That's a no surprise. You didn't know that was happening? It's not always the same transaction. It's very weird. The, where are we going? Okay. We're in a bar. Let's do some bar jokes. There's, I don't know if you're familiar with the Irish Parvo. Anybody like those? Heard of those? Woo! Yeah, they're very delicious drink. It's Irish whiskey into a Guinness. Horrible name, Irish, because I don't know, the history of Ireland has, IRA was just bombing and killing women and children. So we took the 2 favorite drinks of the Irish and we made fun of it with Irish Girl. Hilarious, all right. What if we did that to other cultures? That'd be terrible. You know, we took like a Hennessy and dropped it in Colt 45 and called it a Burning Cross. Not so funny, not so cool, you know? I took a shot of tequila, dropped it in a Corona, called it a border jumper. All right, that's not fun. You know, Jägermeister into a Bex, called it a Holocaust. That's not good, all right? That's not good. No, there was a lady that got arrested. She got a DUI. And she said she just had a couple beers, but her blood alcohol level was 0.40. It's like, hey, they take her to a hospital. Turns out she has what's called auto-brewery syndrome. Yeah. It's where her body naturally creates beer. So she's the life of the party. That's what you need to bring, all right? Tap that ass, all right? Butt chugging makes a lot more sense now. All right, my name's Mike Morris. Thanks for listening, guys.
Slide bar has food now, by the way. If you're hungry, grab a sandwich. They'd be happy to make it for you. Lauren, are you manning the sandwich making abilities tonight? Yes. Okay. Well, good news, Lauren is not making them. So, you don't have any beer, hair, and pubes in them. All right, let's get up to your next comic. You can hear him right on HMBRadio.com. He has a podcast called My Mom's Favorite Podcast. Give it up for my man, Mr. James Bailey.
People tell me I have a problem with drugs. I disagree. My problem is shitty friends. Drugs are my solution. Say marijuana causes memory loss. I disagree with that as well. I feel that marijuana causes memory replacement. You may not remember the name of your first cat, but you'll remember the night you found out it was my old. As I get older, I find that when I go to strip clubs, I'm looking for different things. Like the strip clubs I went to when I was a young man, I was 21, the strippers had names that young men wanted to hear. Coming up next to the stage is Destiny. Welcome to the stage, Passion. Now that I'm old and I go to old man strip clubs, all the strippers have names that grown men want. Coming up next to the stage, pays her own bills on time. Please welcome to the main stage, disease free and no kids. Something happened to me the other day, kind of pissed me off. It's happened to me about 4 or 5 times a month over the course of my life. An older Spanish person will walk up to me, just start speaking Spanish. When I look at them, I go, I'm sorry, I don't know what you're saying, they get mad at me. Why don't you speak Spanish? Why don't you know speak Spanish? You don't care about your heritage? I go, well, first of all, I'm not Spanish. So that's a big reason I don't speak it. But what really pisses me off about it is not once, because I'm mixed, I'm half black. And not once when I tell them that has anybody ever went, well then how come you don't speak Swahili? You don't care about your heritage? You white people tense the fuck up right there. The older white people are used to racism. They're like, yeah, that was funny. I don't actually get that mad when old Spanish people do it, because like they always come up to me, they have really thick accents. And I can tell that Spanish is their first language, and they're just really hopeful and excited to meet somebody that they think they're going to get to speak their first language with. So I'm not that upset when they do it. I do get really pissed off when really white people just start speaking Spanish to me. I'm saying with a really bad accent too. Donde está el baño? I don't know what she said, but the shitter's over there. If you gotta take it down, I don't know what to do with that. I don't drink anymore. I know. I haven't drank for a little over 2 years. I didn't stop drinking because I wanted to. I stopped drinking because I wanted to stop waking up in my neighbor's bushes. Like I said, I don't speak Spanish, but I can tell from context they didn't want me there either. It's changed the way I go to parties, though. Like when I used to drink and go to parties, I only wanted to know 3 things. Where's the keg? Where's the table with the liquor? And where's the girl that'll get drunk enough with me to make some bad life choices? But I don't drink anymore. I just smoke weed. So now when I go to parties, it's different. All I want to know is, where can I smoke this joint? Did I bring enough joints? Where's the girl that'll be bonging with me until we're high enough to make bad life choices? Yeah, there's some consistency. Oh, good. I didn't know what else I wanted to do, so that's perfect. They say, you know, when everybody's heard the expression that when you buy a new car, you start seeing that same car everywhere. Like, I didn't realize how many Cobalts were out there until I bought a Cobalt. And it's true. It really is. It also applies to other aspects of your life. Like, I've finally been single long enough to start seeing how many other men are just dead in the eyes and giving up hope. I'm out. James Bay.
James Bailey is great. Give it up for him. I love how James laughs at his own jokes. Fucking narcissist, like you haven't told these a dozen times. What's the matter with you? Anyway, catch James Bailey on HMBRadio.com every Wednesday. I encourage you to listen. He's a good guy. Very talented. He laughs at his own thing and just said it. Okay, let's give it up for your next comedian. It's International Women's Day. We gotta have a lady. Let's get it out of the way early, right, fellas? Miss Terry McGreevy, give it up.
So nice to be here. So nice to look early enough that my performance enhancing drugs haven't quite worn off. It's so lovely to be here. Oh boy, I just bumped on that one second. We're all sick people sitting tonight. Any crazy people here? Your medication doing you good? I'm gonna tell you, there's no stigma in seeing a therapist these days. It's trending. It's like the thing to do. My own therapist, all she did was ask a lot of really nosy questions. But she sent me to group therapy. Anybody needs group therapy? It's like a little tea party with a bunch of girls getting together. But somebody always starts and says how bad their life's going. And there's the competition. If you think that was bad, and these girls go back and forth, and I have to sit through some of the most lurid tales, it's kind of crazy. Some girls always gone home crying because her husband only hits her open-handed. Anybody tried the online dating? I'm trying to get connected. Anybody successful at online dating? I just have such bad luck. All the liars and the photos are like 10 or 15 years old. So I figured out, and you people can go ahead and copy because it's a damn good idea. I'm going to go to AA meetings to find me a man. The gentlemen stand up and introduce themselves and then lay all their baggage right there. You know, they serve coffee there, and enough guys get up. It's like having six or eight first dates right there. You know, you just hunt and pick what other baggage you're willing to put up with. And if you stay long enough, you can see the kind of cars they drive. Do any still read Cosmo magazine? That Helen Gurley Brown did you guys a lot of favors. 50 things. 50 ways to drive your man wild in bed. 10 things your man wants to hear in bed. Then they don't mind when you're talking. They like it when you talk about their big dicks. But if you call them a big dick, they get all sensitive on you. You ever notice that? It's kind of off-putting. During the day, I'm a diet enhancement. Because they don't call us waitresses anymore. I'm not telling you, it's the only place I have found, but I can get a man to tell me what he wants. Exactly how he wants it, too. You know, admittedly, I get somebody else to do the hard part, but I come back and take all the credit. It's like having 10 or 15 little parties every night, only everybody goes home on time and somebody else cleans up the mess. I must say that I've been looking for a new position in the TBT, that free paper that comes out. But the qualifications are so specific. Like, there's a job, if you have acne, that's the job. It pays $350 and some cream for the acne. Try to cure you. If you have athlete's feet, that's the job. They'll give you $350 and some ointment. That's kind of nice. And if you're troubled by dry vagina, that's a job. They'll pay you to fix it. If you can't shit, if you shit too much, if you can't pee, if you pee too much, that's a job. The qualifications are still too specific for me, but I'm happy to share with everybody. That's a fact. I'd like to thank my friends for coming out and supporting me, but they start drinking martinis about 3 o'clock. It's better that they're just staying home. It's not safe. I've had such a lovely time with you. I hope you don't mind. I talk to each and every one of you about that.
By the way, the light means you have 1 minute left. Sorry, I didn't explain that. That's my fault.
That's all right.
Terry McGregor, everybody. Give it up for Terry. I'll see you on Tinder. I'll see you on Tinder. Hopefully you match up. You never know. By the way, if you meet a guy at an AA meeting and he's hopping into a car, you should call the police because he doesn't have a license. Anywho. All right, let's give it up for your next comedian of the day. I always wondered why this guy only used one initial to spell his name. Now I know. Give it up for Tim Chichnikov. Tasty.
Hello. Thanks for waking up for senior night. We got the band, the group on top. There we go, hey ladies. Okay. I never win this thing, so I'm just gonna rant and see how many people I can piss off.
Okay.
It's a good start. We're gonna talk about dicks and vaginas. Yeah. Welcome. Oh, I'm really glad you came. Yeah, dicks. Okay. Moving along. So, say what you will about cancer. The thing you have it is a great way to pick up women. Man, I have cancer. Are you going out with me? I don't know. I wonder why do all diseases and like sicknesses, you always have something bad from it. Like, you know, the mad cow disease or yellow fever, it's always something bad. It's always a bad sickness. You know, why? Why is there not like a mosquito out there that bites you and your dick grows 2 inches? Like, why is it so big dickitis? Or the big boob flu? There's nothing like that out there. It's always bad shit. I hate it. That'd be a good way to pick up what we're saying, big dickitis. Unless I have cancer and big dickitis. Go on a boat ride with me. I don't know. Remember the song where I just starts like, get down with the sickness? They go, oh, wow! You remember this? You remember the song? You probably haven't. But I feel like that's the sickness. Like, you call into work, hey, Terry, I can't come in today. Big boob flu. I don't know. Okay, next joke. So, cell phones are taking over everything, their lives. Like, you can't leave the house without having that little rectangle in your pocket. Right, you feel lost. You can't do anything about it. And it kind of sucks because we rely so much. Hey, just be all these fucking people, come on in. Just walk through all of the shit. I know it's my fault, but this is going great. You don't even care. So, we, today, we're technology, where we are today, everything. We rely on it to get directions, to order pizza, to look at our bank. We've come so far. You think Alexander Graham Bell, when he invented this thing, really thought he was going to get this far? You really wanted us to communicate with someone across the globe. Now we're using it to take pictures of our cats, our waffles for breakfast, most importantly, our dicks. You think that was his vision? Dicks, pussies, and waffles? Probably not. But here we are. Welcome to comedy. That's what we're talking about. You ever got a dick pic, ma'am?
No.
Never? Have you?
Bullshit.
You're a silly dick pic. Bullshit. Is anyone here? Who's got a dick pic? Clap. What? You will have a dick pic. All right. Why? Why do we do that? Why do men, what kind of this fucking sad, droopy penis? StPete is gonna love it. Click. No. A dick looks like his dog's dying. Every day, it's just droopy. His neighbor's an asshole. I don't know. I wonder, the history behind the dick pic. A couple years ago, it was a carrier pigeon and a Polaroid. Took it off. A couple hundred years ago, it was the Native Americans. Smoke signals. Just big black dick clouds in the sky. This is for you, Kansas and rain. Having a picnic getting rained on. Dick cloud. Oh, just ruined your Sunday. A couple thousand years ago, the cavemen were carved stones into dicks, throwing it across the river. I hope Gronkula gets this. I'm rock hard. That's my time, guys. Thank you.
Tim C, ladies and gentlemen. Tim, I've never seen anybody look worse without a beard than you. It's makeup for men, you idiot. You screwed up. At least it'll come back, I guess. When I saw Tim walking up, I was like, oh good, another homeless person. Good, just turn your back to him. And he's like, hey man. And I was like, oh hey Tim, stop, you look awful. And he was like, I know, sorry. All right, let's just get to your next comedian of the evening, or comedian. Oh, one of my favorites. Give it up for Mr. Jared Walker. Is he here? Are you using the shitter? Here he comes. Come on, keep it going for him while he gets here. Make him feel good.
Hello. How are we feeling tonight? Are we feeling good? Feeling happy? Jazzed to be here? No? That's cool. Woo! All right, thanks, Will. What should I do for you guys? So I used to, I work in IT. Fix computers for a living. You guys know what IT? I'm seeing my blank faces. You're staring at me weird. Like a few computer breaks. Your grandson's out of town, you gotta bring him to me, sir. I'm the IT guy, you know? And one of the things I've found working in IT is that people do not trust the IT guy. A lot of people, more than you would think, have come up to me with a problem like, oh, my computer's not working, what's wrong with it? And I'll look at it, and I'll go, oh, looks like you got a bad hard drive. You're gonna need a new hard drive. And then they will respond with, no, that's not it. What's wrong with it? They're asking me a trick question. I just fucking told you what's wrong with it. It's a hard drive and you need a new one. No, that isn't it. What's wrong? It's like an ongoing, we're both caught in a fucking loop. He's like, what's wrong with it? Your hard drive. Yes, again. I'm like, you tell me then. You came to me, buddy, you know? And I kind of get it, but like, I know what I'm talking about, people. I didn't get laid all through high school to figure out that your hard drive is broken, okay? And what infuriates me is that, like, people come to me and they know that I'm the guy you gotta talk to fix your computer, but at the same time, they'll, like, take their car to the car mechanic who they know is going to rip them off. Like, they'll go to the cop, drive to the car mechanic going, this motherfucker's gonna rip me off. Let's see how much he's gonna overcharge me this week. And then he's gonna go, looks like you need a new engine. It's a bad unicorn filter. And you just go, no, that sounds correct. All of my money, here you go, sir. And then you'll drive away going, motherfucker, rip me off again. Like, it's a weird thing that I don't understand. So, you guys haven't noticed back. And, alright, well, that's a weird... I mean, I guess you're kind of fat, too. We can eat our feelings later or something, but like I don't know about Will, but I'm not a big fan of the buffet, you guys. I'm not. I don't like the buffet because there's just like too much walking involved. I hate that you guys laugh at that. It hurts my feelings a little bit. Actually, one time I said I don't like the buffet, and before I could get to the walking punchline of that joke, I heard someone in the audience go, bullshit. Like, you son of a bitch. Like, that really hurt my feelings, to be honest, but, you know, I get why he said that, because, like, I've been pretty much fat my whole life, so I've heard every fat joke. And, like, as a comic up here on, you know, behind the microphone, I got fat jokes for days, guys. I can tell you fat jokes you ain't even heard of before, you know? But like offstage, it's the opposite. Offstage, you guys got all the fat jokes. And it's not fair to me because I don't have that to go back. Like if we get in an argument, like you and Dean Miss, we like get in an argument where I'm like, your scarf is stupid, it's not even that cold. You can be like, shut up, you fat piece of shit, and walk off. And you just won that argument. Like everyone here would be like, she won. It's not cold enough for the scarf, but he's a bad piece of shit, you know? Everybody wants that. But the opposite's not true. You can't be like, Star Wars is a stupid nerd. And I can't be like, well, you're probably right, but still pretty attractive, and I kind of want to give you a kiss. Like, it's not a good insult, you know what I mean? Like, I can't go back. People just awe at that. What a weird reaction to me awkwardly hitting on this lady in the front row. All right, I'll do one more joke. And I'll get off the stage, but like, I know that I'm fat because like, I recently, like if my mirror wasn't enough confirmation, like I had this experience, like I was walking by myself down the street, and as I walked past like a group of people, I don't know these people, they're living their own lives, I just walked past them, and I heard one of them say something about chicken parmesan, and I had to will myself, all my willpower, not to turn around and join their conversation. Be like, yeah, what's up, chicken parm? Where at? What's going on? Like, I had to be like, no, Jared, keep walking. You have chicken parm at home. You don't need to get involved in there. Like, that's... Thank you guys very much, Jared.
Thank you, Jared.
Jared Walker, you're not fat. Just that big old fat bones. Fine. You're doing good. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up for your next comedian of the evening, the waste of height himself, Mr. Colin Means. Colin!
Welcome, everybody. You're waste of an open mic host. Give it up for him. Always a great guy. So they say everyone has a talent. But my uncle is the best Elvis impersonator, all right? Well, he was the best before he died of an overdose in a Graceland bathroom at this age 42 from prescription drugs. That's how Elvis fucking died. You guys didn't get that joke, that's fine. Okay, so since we started off with a dark joke, let's move on to some fun stuff. So Cat Williams got into an altercation with a Pool Store employee where he apparently went behind the counter and punched the guy, in case you're wondering if washed-up celebrities ever get bored. And he went on to talk about the ordeal to a reporter in a way that can only be described as mentally ill. He said that the employee treated him terribly, and at one point says, he even called me the N-word on the last day of Black History Month. I thought every day was an equally bad day to call someone the N-word, personally. Maybe that's just me. I was unaware that your level of racism progressed as Black History Month got closer to the end. I was not aware of that. As it turns out, if you only get uncomfortable running into a Black person after sunset before February 8th, you're only 2 tiers below MLK on the Civil Rights Movement scale, so you're good. As far as that goes, KKK can't do anything until the last week of February, though, or else they'll be insecure, then everyone will think they're bad at racism. Hey, David, Beautiful's haven't been clean in like 2 weeks, man. Yeah, Joe, take a look at the calendar. We can't even use them until February 21st, or else everyone will think we're pussy, lightweight bigots, all right? We gotta have some strategy to this. So, yeah, that story just goes to show that racists are just dull and bland people. Because that guy still would have rather just said the N-word instead of taking the opportunity, even if it would have been terribly unfunny, to make a stereotypical joke about a Black guy buying pool supplies. Like, I would think that would be on his IQ level. Like, he's thinking, should I ask him who his white friend is who he's buying this for, or just call him the N-word? Think I'll keep it short. Crazy story, guys. So, there are a lot of feel-good stories that make you feel good about humanity, give you hope. They show you there's still some good people left in the world. But then there are other stories that are supposed to be feel-good stories, but once you take a closer look, you realize you're just getting duped into caring about something irrelevant. There's a story about a kid who bought 900 flowers for every girl in his high school for Valentine's Day so that no girl would feel left out. Seems like a great feel-good story on the outside, right? Or did a horny teenager just buy 900 tickets to the pussy lottery and think no one would notice? I noticed. So the story goes that over the years, this kid noticed these girls who weren't getting flowers or anything for Valentine's Day, so he felt bad for them. One year, he decided to buy flowers for all the girls who he assumed wouldn't get anything. What a judgmental asshole to be the one who says, yeah, you probably won't get anything, but don't worry, I'm here for you. Hey, Julie, here's a flower since you're really not all that attractive. Hope that doesn't make adolescence any more confusing than it already is. Sorry. Actually, Kevin got me a flower this year. Oh, an upset. Now he has to come up with a predictive system of which girls are getting hot enough to start getting flowers on their own. Well, Tiffany lost the braces and Jessica has tits now, so I'll have to take them off the pity list. Wasn't planning on Kevin developing an armpit hair fetish, though. That wasn't in the algorithm. I'll have to write that in. But the story gets crazier. He had to get a job so that he could keep buying flowers to give these girls on the off chance that one of them would get with him like a gambling addict. So he decided to let everyone know that he got a job at McDonald's. Nice marketing ploy, McDonald's. Like any guy trying to get attention from a girl would ever admit to working at McDonald's. So, where do you work? Waste management. I'm a garbage man, actually. I definitely don't work at McDonald's. I actually hate McDonald's so much, I wouldn't be able to personally throw the nasty shit away. That's why I got my job as a garbage man. I think McDonald's is a disgrace on humanity, the bane of our existence as a society. I hate McDonald's. I definitely don't work there. I had the job that 4-year-old boys want until one day they woke outside and realized that absolutely any other job would be better. I'm a garbage man. That's the line itself. I wrote it for you. If you're a McDonald's employee, don't worry. Now, so that kid, he bought a flower for every girl in his high school. People were calling him an American hero, but he's not. He's a communist. The Karl Marx of trying to get laid. That's what he is. And on that note, if you guys despise me somewhat, I'll bring up a little.
Yeah! Colin, they just want to see you play basketball, that's all. What could have been, goddamn. All right, let's bring our next comedian. Also white, also very tall. Another waste. Give it up for Zach Townsend.
Thanks, Will. Everybody, give it up for Colin Means, everybody. Truly a talented guy. What other comedian do you know is that loud and that monotone? Honestly. Man of many talents. I got asked a weird question the other day. Somebody asked me, hey man, what's your favorite vegetable? What's the name? I don't know. Apparently Stephen Hawking is not an acceptable answer. I think probably if I had to pick a vegetable though, probably be a carrot. Yes, did you ever have a baby carrot that was so good afterwards you were pro-life? No, more of a fruit crowd? All right. Anybody been through a breakup before?
Yeah.
Yeah, you suck, right? I broke up with my girlfriend recently, and I highly recommend if you're gonna break up with your significant other, definitely get fired from your job like 4 hours later, too. It's really working out for me this week, guys. I'm like killing it. It's fun though. It sucks that I tried to think about it. Like on the way here, I was like, all right, just don't think about it. And then I was listening to the radio and that stupid song comes out by Taylor Swift, like, we are never, ever, ever getting back together. And I can just imagine her and her cunty friends in the car, like, singing it. Like, hey Sarah, here comes the chorus. And they all like point to her and she's really hitting the never, ever, ever. And I'm just like, geez, all right, just don't think about that, change the stage. Like, just don't think about your girlfriend, just don't think about your job. I change the stage, it's that new Rihanna song. It's like, work, 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 work. Definitely gonna drive through a telephone pole tonight. Absolutely. One of my friends tried to console me. He was like, hey man, what do you miss more? Your job or your girlfriend? And I was like, well, honestly, probably my girlfriend, just because I haven't drunk called my job yet. But I know it's coming, like the week I'm having, probably have tomorrow at like 2 p.m. I'm like, hey, what are you doing? Do you miss me yet? You know you're never gonna find a guy who can make burritos like me, you know that, right? I saw your post the other day, now hiring, you slut, you dirty bitch. We still share a Netflix account, me and my ex, which is cool because I get to see what show she's getting fucked to, so that's fun. Parks and Rec, really, Sarah? I thought that was us. Oh man, dating sucks. I don't even want to date, dude. I have no enthusiasm to chase girls at this point. Like, I went on a date with a girl recently, and the first thing she says to me is, hey, I don't mean to bust your bubble or anything, but I'm old-fashioned when it comes to guys. I was like, okay. She was like, yeah, you need to buy me flowers, you need to take me on dates, you need to open these doors for me. I was like, that's fine. I'm old-fashioned when it comes to women, too. Like, I don't think you guys should be able to vote. It didn't go that well afterwards. She didn't really like it after that. She wasn't really into it. You guys ever been so lonely you find yourself responding to an Amber Alert text message? Like, hey, search party at my house? AYLB. Just don't check the basement. This sucks because are you guys like from Florida? You guys like a lot of people from Florida?
Yeah!
Okay, easy buddy. Nobody's ever that excited to be from Florida. I live in Pasco. Are you familiar with Pasco? Guy with way too much enthusiasm? Yeah, okay. I live there, and it sucks that that's the only place you can drink is a strip club in Pasco. For people who don't know what Pasco is, if Florida was the United States, Pasco would be Florida. Just to give you like a gauge. It's just strip clubs. All there is, so like, I can't even go to strip clubs because I'm broke. But I'm not that bad about it, because you ever notice, like, I think they're losing their creativity with like strippers. Like, you ever notice they name themselves after stuff they can't afford? Like diamond or jewel? I'm waiting for them to start getting real about it. Like, listen to the strip club DJ and be like, all right, now everybody give it up for Hot Dog. Now I'm coming to the stage, Hot Dog. Please, don't forget to tip tap water on the way out. Oh, man. Have you ever seen an uncircumcised dick? Is a real question I got asked recently. And I feel like there's so many
less creepy ways you could ask that question. Like, hey man, have you ever seen a bald dude in kind of a baggy turtleneck? Or like, hey man, have you ever had a staring contest with an anteater? Have you ever been to a party where they're serving pigs in a blanket? We can go on, but I've never seen an uncircumcised dick, honestly, for two reasons. One, I had a girlfriend. Two, she was circumcised. And, I don't know. I guess what I'm trying to say, like, I've never performed a circumcision, but I have thrown away the first slice of bread in a loaf before. So, hire me for your next brisk. I need work, please. Alright, I'll go with this. You guys ever play that game, how much money would it cost for you to suck a dick? Yeah, where's your enthusiasm for that one, buddy, huh? Yeah, you fucking stupid. For people who don't know what it is, it usually is a game, because you start like $1 million. It's like guys usually play it when they're drunk. It starts like $1 million. And as the game goes on, you get more reasonable with it. You're like, oh, I got bills to pay, you know, went over my dad last month. Yeah, that game's fun until one of your friends wins the lottery. But whatever, I'm $250 richer, and I'm not texting Tim anytime soon. All right, you guys have been great. Thanks for listening. Here comes your host. Give it up for your host, Chaz Porno. Zach Towns is a good gentleman. Give it up for Zach. I don't know what you all have been doing lately. I've just been kind of kicking back, watching a lot of Parks and Rec with this girl named Sarah. It's been great. It's a callback, but okay. Wasted. Thanks a lot, everybody. All right, let's give it up for your next comedian.
Hey, guys. What's up? My name's Rafoon, like you say. Glad to be here. Glad to see you guys. Some of you guys might have seen me before. Some of you might not have. For those of you who have, you can even tell your friends. I'll be honest, I'm a huge nerd. No getting around it. And I know that's not a big thing to admit anymore, because everybody's a nerd nowadays. You know, all you have to be in order to be a nerd, you have to be so obsessed with something that becomes fucking obnoxious to the rest of us. You know? That's the reason why that we have our standbys. You know, you have your movie nerds and your book nerds. Now we got new nerds today, like football nerds. Okay, I can tell I lost some of you guys when I said that, but trust me, look at anyone who's into fantasy football. Fantasy football is Dungeons and Dragons with fewer dragons, and if you don't count prison sentences, fewer dungeons. That's it. Yeah. I like being a nerd, though. I like learning new things about our world. Like, did you guys know that just this last year they discovered a new planet in our solar system? Yeah, we're up to 10 now. Thank you, Colin. See, the cool thing about it though, right, is they think it took them so long because they think it goes around our sun once every 15,000 years. That's a long ass time to wait for a birthday, isn't it? Right? And I think it's awesome because it raises some really important questions. Like, were your friends who were in a horoscope full of shit before or just now? Right? You look at me like you believe in horoscopes, and that makes me sad. I love learning new things. Well, the thing I learned this past year is they discovered these two really amazing things going on in the Amazon. They discovered a fertility cult, which had never been seen before. And they showed this really cool photo in the bottom right-hand corner of their deity. And it's this real thick, beautiful figure. And the first thought they went on was, oh shit, Freddie Mercury was right. Fat bottom girls really do make their rock and roll around, right? And then the second thing that they discovered in the Amazon is they discovered a slug that's completely different than every other slug they've discovered before. It does something no other slug does. The way it mates is it spits a poison dart at other slugs in order to get them in the mood. Right? How insane is that? What if we did that, right? Like, are you guys together? No? You're so adamant about that, like, no. Right, but imagine if you went home to your girl or your boy, right, and you're just like, hey, baby, I know you've had a long day, but I was thinking, you know, maybe a little wine, maybe a nice hot shower, we can just, and they're like, no, okay. How about now, right? And the cool thing is they haven't come up with a name for it yet, and I realize what we need to call this thing. I don't know, we all need to get together and send them an email. need to convince them to call the Cosby slug. Exactly, because on the surface, it's completely harmless. Underneath, it's a drugging rapist, and we all kind of knew. thank you. I like learning new things. I like learning about myself. Part of the reason why I love science, though, is because science is such an adamant thing. There's no arguing with science, you know? You've never been in a theater and seen someone collapse and someone go, quick! Is there a magician in the house? Like, is this your card, ma'am? You'll be okay. Like, that's never gonna happen. You want a doctor. Because you know, at least with a doctor, when you die, you can sue. Alright, cool. So let's do two more and then get out of here. So ladies, I'm single, as if that was apparent. Yeah. See, I think my biggest problem though is like I can't really date the people I'd like to alive. You know, like I try, you know. It's hard being an African American. Thank you. See, my problem though is I can't really date the people I'd like to, you know, because I can't date black women because I'm never gonna be black. And I can't date white women because I'm never going to be black enough. All right. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, that's going to be my time. Thank you guys so much.
Huge to meet you, ladies and gentlemen. For me, it's a nerd. You know how I know? Because he has a goddamn cell phone holster on his hip. What is the deal? You guys got to stop doing this. It's making us all look bad. Enough with the cell phone. You have a pocket. Put it in your pocket. Matter with you. By the way, the kitchen's about to close, so if you want to put in a food order, please do that now. Cool. Very good. All right, let's give it up for your next comedian, Patrick Welsh, everyone. Give it up for Patrick.
Not a nerd. And I'm married. Coincidence? Because it was just for the married couple. Do you guys ever open the refrigerator and it's empty? And then you remember you're at Lowe's? Just want to start out by saying you just pour in senile at the same time. Anybody else grow up poor in here?
How?
Growing up poor gets a how? How poor did you grow up, ma'am? I'm curious.
Poor as shit.
Poor as shit. Do you have like a good example?
Bread or milk.
Bread or milk? At least you had food. Look at her fucking bragging. Do you guys hear that? I'm sure a lot of you guys grew up like ramen noodle poor, right? We didn't have those when I was younger. But I did grow up poor, and all my dad could serve up was knuckle sandwiches. Thanks, Terry, life and child abuse. Yeah, it's funny, man, I didn't get to go to too many movies growing up, but one time my dad took us to this movie, Mrs. Doubtfire, and it was, what, they were weren't, my parents like weren't getting along very well, and after we walked out of the movie, I like broke down and started crying to my brother, and I was like, man, mom and dad's getting a divorce. And dad's a fucking cross-dresser. I'm gonna talk to you guys. You guys are my audience. Are you guys couples together? Yeah? Did you know there was comedy going on? You're like, where's that? There's been no comedy, right? Did you know there was comedy? I'm just curious. Like, yeah, you did? Are you here for somebody?
No.
Just for the laughter? Cool. I appreciate you guys coming out and supporting me, man. It's nice. Yeah, give it up for that. Oh, shit. I'm just here for surveys, just so you know. Let me ask you guys, anybody have like a good ghost story? Anybody? Like, I've asked multiple crowds, nobody. They're all boring, right? Have you ever heard a good ghost story? Anybody? No? It is, they're always like, oh, the pictures were moved in the middle of the night. I heard one guy saying that, there was puddles of water on the table. He's like, what else could it be but a ghost? Like, why isn't anything good, you know? Like, I was moving out of my house, and all of a sudden, holy shit, all my stuff's in the truck. It's like, thanks, friend, to get good ghost? Right? Why can't we get some good stories like that? Oh man, best massage last night. Now I'm just talking to you, Terry. That's scary when it gets down to just you as my audience. Gay marriage is legal. You guys know that? We have Facebook, I'm sure you're aware, right? Like everybody gayifying their profile pic. Do you guys do the rainbow thing, some of you? Yeah? No? You guys know what I'm talking about, right? Yeah, I changed my pick too, man. Just a black box. Because I gotta tell you, this legalizing gay marriage is like pissing me off. Yes, sir. It's really getting to me because I'm a father and I have three daughters. That's three potential marriages I might have to pay for. Sort of maybe lesbians, you know? No marriage payments. Ace had to go fuck it up for me. Again, just talking to Terry. Awesome. I don't know why. We could just meet somewhere else and we can tell not funny jokes to each other. Okay, man, I'll leave you with this. McDonald's, is anybody still loving it? You guys laugh, I'm guessing that's a no, right? Dude, I still go there every once in a while. I actually saw this not once, but twice at Mickey D's. I saw a family praying before they ate. Still trying to figure out if it was a prayer of thanks or protection. You think God's listening, like, bless the food? Holy shit, how powerful do they think I am? And we got a great comedian coming up next. He's going to really talk about religion to you. So my name's Patrick Welsh, man. I appreciate you guys listening. Patrick Welsh, ladies and gentlemen. McDonald's. What can you say?
You're fucking wrong. I would be the guy who would just let him fucking do what he does. I don't need to call him out. Another one. I don't do anymore because it's a little too believable. What's the bad part about having a dick pump? Nothing. Except for cleaning it. And it's just a little too believable. Like, how many of you guys just pictured that? Things cross the line. Stop it. Okay, moving on. Here's another one I can't do anymore. Is, or just don't want to do anymore. But I'll do it. I don't know what's worse, the fact that every time I do stand up I have a raging erection, or that nobody knows it. Thank you. Way too believable. The bad part is, women still hit on me after that. This advertisement is not false. I just will not please you. Anyways. It's a joke, right? My last joke, ladies and gentlemen. I walked into a TGIF, for those of you that don't know, maybe call it Fridays, maybe? I don't know. I'm surprised you're still here. But it's not a joke. I was on the way to the restroom, and there's a picture, a black and white picture of Muhammad Ali talking, leaning forward over a dinner table with a big grin on his face at the same time, and Bill Cosby's leaning back like this with a big smile on his face, sweaters and all. And this is how I pictured the conversation going. It's just Muhammad Ali's, you know, all over the table. I got so many motherfuckers out! And Bill Cosby's leaning back, smiling because he's like, you know? And by the time it comes out, you won't be able to understand. Let's make fun of the rapist. He should just let go. All right. Thanks very much, guys. My name is Michael Peter. My name is Jason. I'm happy to be here on the table. Thank you. Thank you.
Daba, ladies and gentlemen. Did he explain why he went by Daba? It's your last name? What was the Jamaican thing? You just trying to clown me. I feel like you're just clowning me out. I can't look at this kind of environment.
I've lived here for 15 years.
You're from Jamaica, though, originally.
Yeah, why is that a big deal?
Well, turn to white guys.
There's lots of us down there.
Is there really?
No.
Trying to make things sound bad. Dava, ladies and gentlemen, thank you, Dava. Let's give it up for your next comedian, Mr. Dan Steen.
I just peed in the corner. I was Why in the hell did I take you to Amsterdam? So the last one is kind of tragic. I'm not sure where I'm at on time here, but where am I at? It's too tragic. It involves her hitting a guy in the face with a beer bottle, so we're gonna go ahead and leave it there. All right, thank you. I don't even have to end of that story anyway, so I'm right there.
Dance scene, ladies and gentlemen. Dan, this is the first time I'm like, oh, maybe he is straight. In the ass, like, for 5 minutes. It's good. We'll convert you yet. There's a lot of joy.
Awesome.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we got a few more comments. Stick around. There's Orlando back there. He's bored. He's twirling his bottle opener. Like, I need something to open. What's that?
Your heart's mine.
Oh, I think you said butthole. That would have been better. Alright, so let's give it up for your next comic. Come in, Mr. Tommy Gill.
Woo!
Give it up for Tommy, come on. Come on, let him hear it.
How's it going, everyone?
Hey.
So let's get down to brass tacks. You guys like that song, Come On, Eileen? No? You know it's that song. Come on, Eileen. Oh, you know that song? Ew!
Yeah.
Okay, I'm getting a mixed response, so I'm going to take that as a yes, though. So, for a college drama class, I had to do a dramatic interpretation of Come On, Eileen. You guys want to hear it?
Yeah.
You can handle it?
Woo!
Yeah? Okay, yeah. Let's get hyped, guys. Dramatic interpretation. Okay, let's go. Come on, Eileen! Come on! Or something. Not sure. So. I lost 30 pounds recently. You guys can give it up for that. Don't be shy. On my way to becoming a reformed fat person. That's what's up. No, you guys are thinking. Reformed fat person? You mean like Chris Christie? Nah, you're thinking of a deformed fat person. I like using puns in my act. It's sort of my way of letting the crowd know I'm not really planning on going anywhere with this comedy thing. But yeah, I used to weigh like 250 pounds. It sucked. The worst was when like skinny people would come up to me and complain about their skinny people problems, complain about being too skinny. Like, I didn't give a shit. Like, I had some guy come up to me and be like, Tommy, I want to gain weight. What do you do to gain weight? I'm just a natural, I guess. Yeah, but what do you do? I drink a lot of soda. That's bad for you. What did this become about me? You're the one with the fucking problem, skinny little bitch. Not having any of it right now, guys. I'm just kidding, guys. You guys are pretty awesome. I was watching this YouTube video, and a 30-second ad, and I couldn't skip it. I was just sitting there thinking, whose dick did this guy have to suck? Mark all checkboxes that apply. Okay, that's new. Yes, you forget about that. I think that midgets make for very poor environmentalists. Because, like, if a midget chains himself to a tree, they're still going to get most of that tree. So, here's another thing I hate. I really hate historical reenactors. You guys know about historical reenactments? Like, people dress up in historical garb and reenact wars and history and stuff. It's really boring. Dull. Really dull. Like, it'd be more fun if you got to change stuff, right? Like, let's win Vietnam for a change. You guys with me? No, okay, that's okay. But, if I were gonna go to one of those historical reenactment meetings, I feel like I'd go just, like, screw with people. Let the guy would be like, today we will be reenacting the Battle of Bunker Hill, which occurred in 1775. Dibs on Hitler! This is the Battle of Bunker Hill.
Yeah.
I'm gonna be Hitler. You can't be Hitler. You know, you're acting like a real Jew right now. Sorry, just get any character, you know. I'm a Hitler, as you well know. That's my time, those are my jokes. You guys are awesome. Good on yourselves. Let's go.
Good job, baby.
Tommy Gill, ladies and gentlemen, give it up. I can kind of tell that you used to be fat. I think, do you have an old shirt on from you were fat? You're like baggy down here. You gotta get some form-fitting clothes.
I should, man. I got over the times.
Just go to a thrift shop. They got t-shirts there.
Definitely.
Alright. Just trying to help. Sorry. I don't know. Maybe I'm overstepping my bounds. Sorry.
You can back them off.
It's coming from a fat guy, too, by the way, so don't take too much heat in what I'm saying.
You are right.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we got a few more comments. Are you having a good time? You good? Chris, yeah. See those eyebrows from a mile away. I knew it was just like a beacon. It's nice to see you. Go see Lando. Get a drink. This thing is echoing way too much, is it not? Am I talking too close to it?
Yeah.
Yes, said a woman out there. Thank you, miss. You work at a speaker shop? Okay, let's give it up for your next comic. He is the mascot of StPete, if I were to say. He's a very funny man. Give it up for Mr. Sean Gary. Sean.
How's everybody doing?
All right.
Gonna be reading from something I told myself I wouldn't when I first came here, but regardless. Just want to thank everybody for sticking around, especially my friends that came with me. I know Robin Williams could learn something from you sticking through the hard times.
Oh.
If it looks like I'm nervous or anything, I'm not. Just we had a couple of hot dogs before we came here, so I'm very large, and I feel like OJ before he learned about double indemnity. But I'm gonna shop a little bit of stuff I've been working on. My doctor actually had a really good idea for the title of the eventual 15-minute special I do on YouTube that won't get watched. Everybody's used to that. And he said I should probably call it, I think he said, Morbidly a Beast. And I thought that was really, really cool. Just cool to come out with that out of nowhere. So I'm going to work with that, and I'm going to put my face on it so that you know it's dark comedy when you see it. I know everybody's had their problems with online dating, and I want to sympathize with you, but if you can imagine how hard it is to settle this online, like in person, I'm fun, I got a terrible mohawk. This is just neglect, by the way. it's a little different, but when you see this online, it's basically like a lunch lady that you think is a guy. It's these websites, for some reason, the boxes aren't very considerate, and you fill everything up. It's kind of like the Necronomicon from based on a box, and then when you kind of have that whole Earl Robbie Sinclair thing going on from Dinosaurs, when you walk around and people, I'm not gonna walk for you. Occasionally, I do pull something in. There's a lot of fish in the sea, and a lot of them have very low self-esteem. Hot and ready sensibilities, if you will. The Little Caesars ladies of the online community. But the problem is when you say you were hung like a horse, but it was seahorse and got auto-corrected, or that you fill magnums and it's Dodge magnums, not like so much. That's neither here nor there, but I'm from Brooklyn originally. Went to Brooklyn College, love New York, love everything about it.
Woo!
But one of my, here's my issue. My mother, she came here from Jamaica back in the 60s and so. And, I got a bachelor's degree, done absolutely nothing with it. Thank you. And when she talks about it, like, she came here, she was a maid, then became a CNA. And just to put, like, that whole disparity between her generation and mine, she bought a 3-bedroom house in New York, then bought 3 pieces of property here in Florida. And the way she says it, Sean, you come here as a maid, you don't do nothing with your life, you're just sitting at the house and blah, blah, blah. I thought the Jamaican comedian was going to do that when he came up. I didn't get a taste of my mother and what I deal with every day. But basically, the only thing I learned from getting a bachelor's degree was that I'll probably be alone for the rest of my life. I guess America taught me that. But I hate work. I do customer service for a living. I don't know how many other people do that, but you can probably see it from just the absolute hollow existence, like looking right through them. And if you're ever wondering what that person sounds like on the other end of the line, this is the guy you're yelling at about some super inconsequential shit that's bothering you. So, I work for a home shopping network. If you're familiar with it, don't applaud.
Sorry!
I'm the one selling your grandmother's snow shovels and skinny jeans and, you know, all the power saws that they think they need because we have a British guy on air telling him that it's the last one they'll ever meet. It's beautiful. Your grandson, your granddaughter, your whole family will love it. And they think he's so charming when he's really just an asshole who walks by all of us in the call center like, fucking trash. But, you know, I also, because I sound so...
Was it good?
Brian Gumbelish. And my name is Sean. When they call in, they think that I'm Irish. And because I'm trying to get off the fucking phone in less than 3 minutes, I tell them, sure am, I'm Irish every time. And I have to have these conversations about their hip surgery and their grandchildren and unfortunately a lot of long conversations about what Obama's doing to this country. If you can imagine, whenever you hear about a man-made disaster, so to speak, or someone absolutely losing their shit, I know you probably go, oh my God, that's awful. I can't believe something like that happened. When you work in the service industry, you kind of go, that's sad, but I can kind of see how something like that can happen when somebody tells me a piece of shit because, you know, their underwear came in and the stitch was off. I don't know. But I actually tried to call out of work last week when we got those Amber Alerts. I know that makes me a terrible person. But I told them, you know, I know they knew what was happening, and I just took enough pictures and they didn't think I was going to do something about it. I'm a Bernie supporter, but I try not to say it.
Yeah! Because
everybody gets so hostile about that division, but I don't remember all that much. But I'm really hoping that, you know, people say he's very old and may not have a chance to make it through his presidency, or sorry, his presidency, Jesus Christ. But, I mean, even though I know people have probably told this joke before, I would really love to see them even try a weekend at Bernie Sanders type of thing, where they just kind of bring in help for the toss and everything and throw cool sunglasses on them. But, I don't know, worst case scenario, I'm just picking these popular millennials, so, or millennials, maybe there'll be a glory hole in the booth. So, thank you guys, I'll show you guys.
I'm Gary, ladies and gentlemen. I'm just stoked to have a wax here now. We had a treat tonight, and a guy that said he was black, who is not, he's a white Jamaican guy. Poor shit. It's nice to see. All right, give it up. We got a couple more. You guys still good? This white shirt, you got your hand on the bar, and your fist to your head. You want to go to bed. Three more, we can get out of here. So give it up for your next comedian. You look very stiff. What are you doing?
Pre-gaming.
Okay. He's stretching out. He's high as hell. Give it up for Justin Cooper.
Thank you, Rokas. So, my friends tell me that I smoke like a chimney, which, you know, I guess is their way of trying to get me to quit, but, jokes on them, because I've never heard of a chimney getting cancer. No? The joke's got a radiation. If you like that one, you're gonna love this one. You think the first guy that was told he had cancer was like, what is can? Sir?
No.
Okay, moving away from the illness-related jokes. I think it'd be really tough to be a starving artist.
but I think it'd be even more tough to be an overfed artist. Because how would you have time to paint it while you're doing eating? Next year.
That was just not meant to be.
If I could have any superpower, it'd be whichever one gets me the biggest movie deal. You guys are just respecting me, and I appreciate that. Just sitting in quiet admiration. I don't trust people with the name Buddy because their name is an assumption. I'm not a guy named Buddy today, so like I can't call you that. I think if you wear a wig and you lose it, that's the universe's way of telling you that you're not meant to have hair. No. Oh boy, it's cold out and I'm sweating. I want to open a vintage eyeglass store and call it In Retrospects. If you're talking to somebody with diabetes, be honest with them. You can't sugarcoat things. Just way too soon for diabetes cures. Wait till we cure it, then we can laugh. In other countries, people are living in huts. Here, we're ordering pizza now. Every tattoo is a temporary tattoo if you're a leper. I want to open a landscaping business and call it Motown. My already trademarked. I went to this restaurant the other night where the head chef had Down syndrome. The entire menu was a special. Bastard. Oh, God. But, you know, if you think that joke's mean, just know that I actually have a cousin who's severely dyslexic. Just yesterday, he got arrested for stealing a baby from winning candy. Take a second. One time he got stoned and killed two birds. Very dyslexic. Oh boy. We're gonna feel so. So it turns out that a spoonful of sugar doesn't really help if you take your medicine rectally. Good pro tip. Life hack. Alright, we're gonna. Says going to school. One more. Alright. Has anybody else ever wanted to go to the US-Mexico border and yell Red Rover? I'll leave you with this one. You know, if you think about it, technically Hitler was a German Shepherd. Thank you guys. Justin Cooper, ladies and gentlemen, give it up for him. I've never seen Justin bomb that hard. I got a lot of joy watching that. That was fun for me. Thank you for not applauding Justin for once. It makes me feel better. All right, so we got a couple more comics, and then we're going to go home. Let's give it up as we fulfill our quotas here on International Women's Day. Another lady.
International Women's
Day. Is Victoria. Give it up for Victoria.
Motown enough love. Are you serious? Are you serious right now?
It's a good
one. My goodness.
Yeah.
Do you get it? Like they mo? Okay, I'm sorry. I'll give you a second. I know Justin Trupo. You have to like re-Trupo right after. Oh my gosh. It is International Women's Day, whatever the fuck that means. I think I'm supposed to be a feminist, but I'm like not really because I think like feminists think that we're supposed to be equal. I don't think we're equal. I think we're, let's figure that. I hate when people assume that fat girls are easy. Like, you're not wrong, it's just rude to assume. I love that, because you could, like, hear a fucking pin drop. Like, oh, we're off with some dude. I did not see anyone, what's happening? And then a lot of guys usually do jokes, they're like, oh, fat girls, like, they give the best blowjobs. And, like, I mean, you're still right, but I just don't like it because we typically have very weak knees. So, that just seems kind of inaccurate. I don't know. Gotta get some braces or something. I don't know what to do about it. And also, like, Captain, I just want to say, like, don't flatter yourselves. You know, like, we just love to have things in our mouth. And, like, it could be your dick, or, like, it could be a cookie. You know, like, I really don't care either way. Hopefully we don't confuse the two, that's all I'm saying. I thought it was a biscotti. It was a horrible accident. It was a horrible, horrible accident. And it's just like a lot of pressure now. It's like with this assumption, like now I have to be afraid that I'm gonna like let the fat girl race down or something, you know, with some improper technique, or I don't have any classes or like a workshop, or I'm sure I'll find a volunteer. I feel certain in that. But actually, I did find a volunteer. I think I have a boyfriend. I don't know. I think so. But it's weird. I don't even know what to do. Like, do you need to feed them or water them or walk them? Like, I don't know. It's like really stressful. I don't know. I don't know what I'm supposed to do. And it's funny, if you want to know, you know, who kind of catches a beauty like me, I seem to attract homosexuals, potheads, and homosexual potheads. So I'll let you know, you can guess which one he is. Clearly the homosexual pothead. But yeah, somebody else called me beautiful recently, which is like really unsettling. Like, I don't know how to respond to that. So I just said, yeah. Like, I don't know if that was the right response. I don't know what you're supposed to say. But I think, like, I've got you guys figured out, you know, like, whenever you say, hey, you look beautiful, hey, you look cute, like, you're actually just saying that you look easy. So I just still said, yeah. You know, I thought that was still work. It's funny, I joke about it, but I'm actually like a super prude. Like, I'm just like, what, you want to put what, where? Like we could do that, or I could just like leave. You know, like we could just one or the other. We leave it? Okay, I'll do that. That'll be totally fine. But yeah, I am super excited, super jazzed about this whole BBW movement. If you're unfamiliar, BBW, Big Beautiful Woman. It used to be Big Black Woman. But then we stole it because it's kind of our thing. And it's crazy because it's like a whole new world, you know. I was totally unfamiliar just with the whole, like, the reason I love being a part of the community is because I'm considered petite. And that's a community I want to be a part of, obviously. But the girls can be so cool to me, you know? Like, I hear them whisper about me as I walk around Lane Bryant. Like, they can say such hurtful things, you know? Like, do her thighs even rub together? Like, how rude? Like, I'm in here every week buying new jeans and start a fire. Like, anyway, it's cool though. It's even shown up in pop culture. I'll leave you with a quote from the Book of Drake. He says, silence, please. He says, I like my girls BBW. I'm going to paraphrase, sorry, because I'm a lady. He says, I like my girls BBW, the type that'll blow you, then have lunch with you. And I just kind of like, Drake. Okay, so what was that part about lunch again? Are you buying a lunch? Good night, everybody.
Holy shit, I'm glad I'm a guy. Wow. International Women's Day has taught me a lesson today. Y'all good? You feeling okay? A little sleepy?
No.
Okay, bye, man. No, okay. We got a couple more comics. Give it up to the next one. I think this guy is new, I think, to Slide Bar, so give him a warm welcome. I know he's going to say everything you have, but give it up for Mr. John Lewis.
What's up, everybody? Where did the Jamaican guy go? He totally stole my opener because, like, I am going to be a dad. When I heard it, I was like, nah, I'm lying, just like him. But don't feel that, because like, it's not the first time in my life I have this thing where I go to karaoke bars. Oh, there you are, I'm sorry. There you are. So I have this thing where I go to karaoke bars, right? And I get on stage, like, kind of like this, right? And I get up there and I'm like, guys, yeah, the kid today, I just found out everybody doesn't do shit. But what I do is I sing Creed with arms wide open, and I get up there, and by the end of the song, there's like two, like 45-year-old wasted dudes in this dive bar. They're like, oh my god, dude, it's gonna change your life. And they give me hugs, and then they give me the free beer. And that is what I do at dive bars. So, have you ever had a moment where you realize you're a true alcoholic? Like, I've never sucked dick for High Life or, like, donated an organ or anything. I have donated plasma. That's kind of weird, but, like, that's irrelevant. But I was at Publix, and my ex-girlfriend and I were alcoholics, and I buy a bunch of tall boys, and I buy three bottles of champagne for her, right? So when you're putting that kind of merch up on the table, somebody always has some sly-ass comment for you, right? So I go up there one day, and there's like this old lady who definitely didn't save enough for retirement, and this cutie pie who's bagging my groceries. And we've had some flirtatious moments in the past. So she's like, aw, you're having a party without me? And as I go to say something, she's like, no, sweetheart, he's in here every day. You don't want to go to that party. And then I realized, fuck, now I have to go 5 more miles to the next Publix. And but this country has become way too self-important for me, and by country I mean Facebook. Like, people are announcing their jobs like they just become the CEO of fucking Goldman Sachs. Like, I am proud to announce I am now the new sanitation engineer at Happy Stable Farm. Nah, bitch, you pick up horse shit. Chill the fuck out. It's ridiculous. And I don't know if you've ever had this awkward moment. You definitely haven't, but I have, where your dad has a gay talk with you. I was like 17 or 18. And I was smoking a lot of pot, hiding in our room. He called me into his room one day. And I was like, oh shit, here it is. Found the weed. And granted, when you buy weed as a high schooler, $30 is a fuckload of money, right? Somebody does. So I was like, ah, damn it. So I walk in, my dad, military man, looks at me, John, I want you to be honest with me right now. Sure, Dad. Are you gay? And at that moment, I realized, if I said yes, my curfew would be cut entirely off. So I responded, yes! Alright. Who's a fan of Bernie Sanders in here? I heard Now, what if Bernie was actually secretly undercover like an OG, right? Like he's in some Jacksonville town hall meeting, some kid stands up and he's like, Bernie, what are we gonna do about these white girls without no ass? Thinking he's not gonna respond. But secret OG Bernie is like,
I'm glad you brought this up. I have a plan to eradicate the people who only 1% of the ass in this country. We need to distribute hookahs, keister to all people in this country. Now, I know that I am the only person on the stand that is not taking money from Wall Street or 106 and Park. If you can ask, we'll be next year.
I haven't gotten a lot before. But Bernie's still real. Hold on.
Now, what I plan to do is to redistribute everything. And Hillary, I know Bill wants to top that, so I'll put a little money in for you and redistribute that as too.
Alright. You guys are alright. Thank you for having me.
John Lewis, ladies and gentlemen. Your Jew sounds like an army.
Yes.
You know, this is coming from a guy whose Jamaican accent sounds like an Irish man, so you gotta keep that in mind too. Alright, we got one more, and then we're gonna give away the money, then we're gonna go home. Or you can say a drink if you want to. Give it up for my man, Mr. Elijah Fernandez. What's up? How you doing?
Woo!
Alright.
Woo!
Fuck me though.
Elijah!
Oh. Anybody here? We hear our phone? We hear our phone? Ladies, y'all got phones?
I got a phone.
I gotta make more phone calls, man. I text way too much. Y'all ever text so much you forget you're driving? You drive up to like, oh shit! It's crazy. That's why we need more dangerous roads, man. There needs to be like obstacles and oil slicks and turtles and bananas and shit. You never texted while you was playing Mario Kart, have you? Because that's just dangerous. You got things to do. I got one of those self-driving cars. Yeah, it's just not good at doing it. This thing's a brick in a direction. I'm gonna give him a license. Hey man, you can let it out, man. It's okay. Yeah, okay.
Let it all out.
Me and my girlfriend are a lot alike. We actually used to have way more in common when she was really new, though. Y'all down? Y'all get that one? Y'all get that one? I feel like if you're transgender, that should be the most interesting thing about you. Have a personality. That's all you can talk about, man. Get a better job. Some people lie about like how good their life is. They're like, man, I got a Porsche or whatever. Just get some pussy. But I lie about how cheating my life is, man. I'd be like, they're like, what do you do? They're like, oh, I was addicted to heroin. And they're like, what do you do now? Like, I work at Walmart. They're like, good for you, man. You really know what's up to be like. Oh, I forgot y'all were here. Because I couldn't hear you. This is stupid. I found a list. My sister had this list, like, just on the kitchen counter, and it was of all the women, of all the dudes she slept with. And I was like, what the fuck is this? And she was like, it's the list of all the dudes I slept with. The weird thing was, it was categorized by conscious and unconscious sex. She was freaky, man. I was like, what do you mean unconscious? She's like, I just don't remember it. And I was like, do you feel like you got raped? And she was like, nah, I don't really care. Isn't that weird? I feel like part of her is being a strong woman. I don't get the dudes who did that. You know what I mean? It's like, why would you want to have sex with a woman who's unconscious? You can't even get to see their face of like sympathy and regret, you know? Like, I shouldn't have started this, but go ahead and finish, you know? Feels like I want something. It's the same face, ladies, you see when you're in a 10-minute store with no ending. Where it's like, we shouldn't have asked. But, alright. I'm living in the apartment with my sister. I sleep on the floor or the couch. It's stupid, but I feel like I'm practicing for like a 20-year loveless marriage. We don't have any sex. I'm not complaining. I got a friend who's like, he's really stupid. He's like, I don't get why people don't just have sex with their siblings. And I was like, well, evolutionary speaking, it doesn't matter. You got the same genes. There's no reason to pass the genes on, you know? He goes, yeah, but wouldn't it be fun? I was like, bro, if every woman you slept with showed up at Thanksgiving, would you want that? So stupid. I was listening to my neighbors have sex through the wall with a stethoscope. And I could tell they were having a good time. She was like, oh. I was listening. Oh, I can sense. I was like, oh. that's not funny. What is this? You ever hear a girl have sex with a wall? She's like, Jeff, and you listen, like, my boyfriend's name isn't Jeff. My decision, though. That's so stupid. Oh, you know what? I kind of want to have a kid, ladies. I feel like having a kid really teaches me responsibility when I buy my dog. Thanks, dog. My friend told me if you watch too much pornography, you can get desensitized to it. Luckily, I know I'm not desensitized to porn, because when I watch it, I still cry, you know? I'm just like,
why could my mom do this on me like that?
Does she know her parents?
No, I'll just get serious. Like, damn, that's gotta hurt.
You know what's cool is like, your poor name is the name of the street you grew up on and name your first pet. So like mine's like Roger Belair. That's a pretty cool name, right? But like, what if you grew up in the inner city and be like 34th and Goldfish? So, weird thing was you named the Goldfish Goldfish.
That's fun. I can't remember anymore, so thank you for letting me try that out. Come back, you guys.
Elijah,
will you show up earlier?
I slept till like 9:30, dog. I apologize.
You slept till 9:30 at night?
So I just got a job, and I just remember how hard it was to wake up, like when the sun was like rising.
Daytime.
Yeah.
I feel like I don't need to talk on the mic because everybody can hear us. But what is your job now?
I just got a job making phone calls at the comedy club.
Yeah.
Give it up for Elijah. Yeah. Good job. Show up earlier next time. Now call or something. This mic is getting worse by the minute. Does anybody hear this?
Yeah.
Good. I guess it's doing the job.
What?
Huh?
What?
Alright, so here's what we're going to do. I have secret people in the audience who are keeping track, and we have a top three, right? So I need your help, everybody. So I need Terry McGreevy, I need Sean Gary, and I need Hannah Bertram to come up to the front of the stage. Nice job.
2 years.
I have that back. Okay, so here's how we're going to do this, everybody. So I'm going to humiliate these people, put my hand over their heads, and I need you to applaud. Applaud for everybody, but maybe just like golf clap for the one you like the least,
right?
And really give it to the person you think you should win, okay? We clear? We
guess?
Alright, so Terry McGreevy, right? Sean Gary, right here. So we've got the new champion, Mr. Sean Gary. For our first year Cam, take it over 10. Cam loves black people. And Terry, have a drink on the slide bar. Thank you very much, everybody. I like you more than a friend. We'll see you in 2 weeks. Good night.